These sculptures are not what they seem. They aren't antiquities owned by a wealthy collector. They aren't in a museum collection. And what looks like bronze or stone is actually plastic. These sculptures were all made by Cosmo Wenman using a consumer-grade 3D printer. Many of them are copies of ancient works of art.
This particular piece is called Head of a Horse of Selena, and it's in a corner of the roof of the Parthenon itself, and the original is in white marble.
These horse heads are bigger than what is normally printed on these machines.
And so I decided to cut the design into a bunch of different pieces. This is actually 29 separate pieces that I printed individually and then assembled. And these are both life-size, one-to-one with the original. They both weigh about 8 pounds each, and maybe about $150 worth of material.
We asked Wenman to show us how the printer works. We decided to make a small version of an artwork San Diegans are familiar with.
So we're making a miniature test print of Barbara Hepworth's 1960 figure for landscape, which I scanned at the San Diego Museum of Art.
Wenman begins by photographing the artwork he's selected.
When I'm taking the photos, I take low angles, medium angles, high angles of the entire, all 360 sides, so I can get every detail.
Wenman has photographed antiquities in museums here in the States and in Europe. Sometimes he takes up to 1,000 photographs of just one sculpture, which has drawn the attention of museum security guards.
They're used to seeing enthusiastic photographers, so I imagine I might look like just a particularly nutty one, taking a lot more photos than most.
The photographs get run through a software program that creates a virtual 3D design that the printer can read. That information is put on a memory card, which is inserted into the 3D printer. Turn it on, and it starts building.
So this is essentially a hot glue gun on a printer axis. It can move left, right, up and down, forward and back. There's plastic feeding down to it from above on a spool, and it's depositing the plastic on a layer on a platform, and it's going to move down, deposit another layer, move down, deposit another layer, and build the thing from the bottom up.
Because this is a small print, it was done in about 45 minutes. The Hepworth sculpture is not the kind of artwork Wenman typically prints. He mostly sticks to antiquities. I asked him why.
Two reasons. There's lots of them. I like them. And they're copyright free.
Antiquities are in the public domain. A museum may own the work, but if the copyright has expired, anyone can copy it. Some museums, like the Smithsonian, are in the process of capturing or digitizing select pieces in their collection for 3D modeling. Wenman is hoping they share that information with the public so they can download it.
It is now possible to mass digitize sculptural art, and people will download what they want and share what they already love and want other people to see, and other people will remix them in interesting, novel ways.
Wenman says 3D copies of famous artworks offer plenty of educational possibilities.
Just to be able to have hands-on access to a model, whether it's an art history class or an art class or a history class, or now I can finally show my art students this model up close, where I would have had to pay $500 for a resin model from the museum gift store. People will find their own uses.
Wenman recently showed one of the printed horse heads at the big consumer electronics show in Vegas.
But at one point, I looked over and I saw somebody actually had their hands all over it, was like exploring it with their hands. And I'm thinking, oh my God, I hope they don't break it or something. And then he turned around and I realized he was blind.
That was an application Wenman never thought of.
And that person would never have been able to explore the original marble in the British Museum. That just would not happen.
And that's what's so exciting about this new technology. It could inform how we interact with art and how we preserve the world's cultural heritage for future generations. Angela Carone, KPBS News.